video. Yeah, of course we get a fucking advertisement! Damn right!
Video player. Video is the pod.
Forget about me. Awesome sauce! Yeah. You're gonna learn today! You're gonna learn today! Awesome sauce! This was, without a shadow of a doubt, the better of the two Molly Ringwald movies. Molly Ringwald was a sex symbol back in the 80s. I don't give a fuck what you all say. Molly Ringwald is awesome. So, and she was better in the back of Breakfast Club than she was in 16 Candles. Plus, Ducky was a little bitch. I mean, the Breakfast Club was just awesome and amazing. You had a brain, you had a criminal, you had a basket case, you had a jock, you had a princess. They all hung out in the library on a fucking Saturday. What high school gets detentions on a Saturday anyway? What's up with that? I mean, this song was just like the song of a generation. The Brat Pack was the movie click of a generation. You best testify! Testify! Awesome Comics Podcast, you all gonna learn today with your mentally undeveloped party host, Blair Adam at the helm, leading the Starship Awesome Sauce into a new frontier today! La 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 la! La 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 la! La la la! Awesome sauce! Bitches! Hello, folks! This is your mentally undeveloped party host, Blind Adam. Here in the soon-to-be former Awesome Sauce Comics Studio, in Ramsey, New Jersey. I learned today that in the last 2 days that the hardest part of packing is making sure your entire life and your life possessions fit into a box. And after all, I'm starting to believe that's all life is a series of boxes. I mean, we all start out in the crib. And a crib is shaped like a prison box. Shaped like a prison box. But it's still a box. And then, you learn how to stand. And as I learned from Master Splinter today, we must
Video.
We must fall many times before we learn to stand.
Landscape. Simple.
Oh, that was simple. Don't forget me, it's done by a band called Simple Minds, by the way.
App switcher. Home. YouTube. Close YouTube. Portrait.
For now.
Home.
I'll call YouTube for a few minutes.
Swipe up with three fingers, you know, to close the app.
But then, you know, you learn how to stand as a baby and you learn how to crawl. And then your parents, they stick you in a playpen. Which, once again, they put you there, they give you, like, maybe a stuffed teddy bear and a rattle and one of those, like, TV thingies. And all that good shit, and that's shaped like a litter box. I know, and most of you can see the bed over there, but look at that, that's shaped like a rectangular box. You know, the dresser there, that's shaped like a log data box. After all, as I used to joke around, the only two guarantees in life are death and taxes, and we all wind up in a box. So I think that the lesson of the day, and that this lesson is brought to you by the official pizzeria. Hey, Joey Slap, that's how you doing, buddy? Yeah, buddy. Hey, buddy, Joey. Joey Slap, dudes! Sal's Pizza Corner, 71 Lisbon Street, Ramsey, New Jersey, 07446, 201-327-8929. Sal's Pizza Corner, home with a nice slice. Yeah. You know, but, Joey, you've been an amazing friend to me. I thank you for the love and support of the podcast. And, you know, I'll see you when you get home from your vacation. I think they let you back into the country, that is. You know, but I hope you, the wife, the kids, you're having an amazing vacation. I love you. You know, can't believe you actually took a vacation. Because I walked into your store 15 years ago, and I gained more than just a good lunch. I gained a friend, a brother, an advisor, a fellow class clown. And as I move into the next chapter of the Awesome Sauce comic story, I'm going to come back, we're going to eat pizzas, we're going to tell jokes, we're going to go cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs. As I move into the next box, because like I said, life is just a series of boxes, man. You know, I got 2 weeks, 5 days left in Ramsey as a resident. Doesn't mean I'm not going to take Uber, the official transportation system. Go to uber.com. Set up your account today. A lot better than a cab. Money never exchanged hits. Uber is just awesome. So, still got to set up the account. Man, that echo just sounds weird here. You know, but I thank you all for being an awesome sauce family. I thank you all for the last 3 months of support, love, friendship, interviews. I cannot wait to interview my good friend who wrote the Silver Age of Comics, Arlen Schumer, tomorrow on the podcast. You know, I cannot wait later on to go get some brunch from my B&J Bagels, 84 East Main Street, Ramsey, New Jersey, 07446-201-962-8600. Santa, I love you, brother. And whenever I go there tomorrow for breakfast, that's if Ramsey Theater is still playing the Minions at 2:00 tomorrow. Maybe I'll gonna go for breakfast over at BJ Bagels tomorrow, because I want to be able to walk and just be able to get breakfast. And maybe even bump into my auntie one more time, because, you know, I want to see if I can maybe make an appointment to get my nails professionally done. Manny, Petty. Go cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs! Cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs! You know, but the key to life is really just to help one another, to be good to one another, to be good to yourself, to, you know, have a goal, see what you need to make that goal happen, and then make the goal happen. You know, I'm just so blessed, and I thank you all. And with that, I'm gonna play a song. Because according to Joey Slap, that's how I do on this thing, is talk out of my ass and play songs. So that this song goes out to Joey Slapdust. Open YouTube. Actually, this is also for Joey.
Looking.
Yeah, fuck you. What is 0 divided by 0?
Imagine that you have 0 cookies and you split them evenly among 0 friends. How many cookies does each person get? See, it doesn't make sense. And Cookie Monster is that there are no cookies, and you are sad that you have no friends.
Open YouTube!
Music. The new Discovery Sport Music. Selected. What you want? Menu. What you want? Search. Button. Text feed. Voice search. Button.
And Joey Slapnuts, thank you for showing me that trick. I thought your little kids had a babysit over the weekend for it. It was hysterical and amazing.
Text voice search button.
Now this one, this song is just for you. I think we'll do, yeah, we're gonna do a clean song. We're gonna do Dust in the Wind by Kansas.
Voice search.
Dust in the Wind.
Channel, playlist, refund, resolve, Kansas, Dust in the Wind, official video, 45. Video player, heading.
Before I tell you exactly what you
should do, can now be skipped.
Let me explain to you the 3 steps involved in implanting a tube. The first step in implanting a tooth is actually placing the dental implant. The implant is placed in the gong and must heal.
Video skip ad button.
Doesn't matter!
Video player heading.
This is for you, Joey. I love you, and I thank you for being a part of my life. And, Excelsior, onward, upward! For Awesome Sauce Comics, South Pizza Corner. And I got an idea I'm going to pitch to you when I get home. When you get home.
Thank you.
got that. Is Kansas stuck in the wind?
Kansas. Dust. App switcher. Home. YouTube. Close YouTube. Portrait. Home. Home.
And that takes care of that and that. And that was Kansas Dust in the Wind. That goes out to, what is to the official pizzeria of the Awesome Sauce Comics podcast, where the home of the nice slice, so you are welcome for boo, woohoo! Joey Slapnuts in the Heat's House, 71 West Main Street, Ramsey, New Jersey, 07446-201-327-8929. Tell them Bud Adam sent you, and get a nice slice today. I think I might do that after this episode, maybe. Make some phone calls. Buy my Marvel Tales 137 Nabisco variants off of eBay, so I can get those signed and signatures and series and put them in the Awesome Sauce Comics eBay store. You know, at the Boston Comic Con, and the Boston Comic Con does happen July 31st, August 1st, and August 2nd. Stan Lee is their guest of honor. They have an amazing and awesome sauce guest list. You know, like I said, Stan the Man Lee, the man, the myth, the motherfucking legend himself. Stan Lee, man, co-created Spider-Man, the X-Men, Iron Man, the Avengers, brought Captain America back in the modern comics after being out of publication for a couple of years. I think Young Allies was in 54, ended in 54. Avengers number 4, the issue where they bring Steve Rogers back into the Marvel Age of Comics, so 63. So you got almost a decade, maybe 9 years or so in between publication dates. The first Silver Age appearance, A Strange Tale of... Duh! Get the facts right, biatch! You have to school. Where's the puppet? I have a new edition. This is the wrong set. Pimpy the sock popper, and I'm joining your podcast today. Well, and you gotta stop yelling at me, because I don't read every comic book, you know, I don't watch every TV show like you. I have a life out in Sockland. I'm the leader of the Sock Nation, you know? But I come here from the fifth dimension and shit, and you just gotta learn to respect my...
Screen locked.
Shut up, iPhone! We're talking over here! Authority! Respect your authority? You're talking about Pimpy, you know Eric Carmen. That's true. But, you were saying I made a mistake? Well, yeah. I was trying to correct you made a mistake, Adam. You know? Captain America, his first Silver Age appearance in Strange Tales 114. And... you know, that was just a tryout issue before they put back the Avengers in Avengers number 4. But do go on with your bad self, because I'm Pippin, the sock puppet, and I like the pimp, yo! P-I-M-P, positive, inspiration, motivated people is what the Awesome Sauce Comic Podcast be all about. Now go back with your bad self, Adam, sirs!
Stop recording 2014.
Alright, people, I guess we lost it. Now we got a sock puppet on the show. Hello, y'all. I'm not really decorated yet because I'm being birthed. But I'm Pippi, the sock puppet, for your enjoyment, man. Yeah, but I got Stan the Man, Lee of Boston Comic Con, Robert Lord Taylor, who plays Cobblepot on Gotham. Jillian, the sexy and bellacious Jillian Anderson of X-Files fame. Thomas Jane, the Punisher. Evan Dorkin, the creator of Milk and Cheese, Dork, the Yeltsin Club from Adult Swim, Sarah Dwyer, Brian Azzarello, you got some great creators. Gonna be lots and lots of fun. There's gonna be a boat party. I think it's either Friday or Saturday night, a costume contest. Stanley will be there all 3 days. Testify! That's right, Pippi, do it again. Testify! Awesome sauce! See Pippi be giving the thumbs up with the awesome sauce! Yeah, you tell her, Pippi. Yeah, that's right, man. So go on your bed, still. Yeah. But November 21st and 22nd is going to be a great convention up in Massachusetts. You know? All us Masshole fanboys will be together in Framingham, Massachusetts, at the Sheraton. You know, you can get your Super Mega Fest $100 13 rate at the Sheraton, Framingham. November 21st and 22nd, Kenny Lawrence, the proprietor of Super Mega Fest, will be bringing a great convention to us with, you know, a great guest list. You got John Schneider. You got Catherine Bach. You got Tom, what's his name? It doesn't matter what his name is! But you're going to have all three members of the Dukes of Hazzard cast. And I don't know how smart of a move this is with all the controversy going on. But I hear he's going to have a General Lee. You know, and stuff. That's going to be awesome. You got Lee Merriweather, Miss USA, Catwoman from the 1966 movie. You got Bob Camp, co-creator of Ren and Stimpy. And just going to be an awesome, amazing convention. I'm going to have Kenny on in a couple weeks to talk about it. I'm going to definitely talk to Kenny about appearing in the Friday Night Comedy Show. I'm also going to see maybe if yours truly can host a Q&A with one of the guests. And will you testify on it? Yeah, I'll testify? Yeah? And will you take me to Sal's Pizza so I can make sure I slap this too? Yeah, Pimpy. Can I do my podcast, please? Go ahead with your bad self, boy! But, outside of Boston Comic Con in July and August, and, Super Mega Fest in November, are there any other awesome shows of comic book done that you're gonna go to, my boy? Well, what we are gonna go to is the Mohican Sun. There'll be the Connecticut Comic Con, August 15th, 16th, and 17th. And who's gonna be there, Adam, man? Well, Pimpy, who's going to be there is, Pimp Mike. Can I call you Pimp Mike? Yeah, I'm Pimp Mike from the Fifth Dimension. Yeah, and I'm your biggest fan, Adam, sir, Brian Adam. Who's going to be at this Connecticut Comic-Con? Well, you got John Muschenschiff from the 1990s Flash TV show, and Henry Allen, and possibly Jade Garrick in season 2. I heard that they cast them. I didn't hear who they cast Jade Garrick to be yet. Hopefully they're going to do it right now and be the Golden Age Flash. And did you know that the episode where they bring the Jade Garrick comic in the Flash TV show and the comic book first appearance where they meet is the same? 1, 2, 3? Yeah? Yeah, Pimp Mike. Alright, I'm gonna be quiet. And I'm gonna go take a rest back in the Fifth Dimension. Catch you later, Adam, sir! Alright, and that was the Pimp Mike, my biggest fan from the Fifth Dimension. Testify! We'll have developed Pimp Mike coming soon. But yeah, August 15th, 16th, and 17th, you got John Lushky Shipp from the Flash TV show being a guest at Connecticut Comic Con. You got Greg Grunberg from Heroes, Star Wars, The Force Awakens, Heroes Reborn, which looks amazing. If you all seen the trailer yet. My good buddy Brimstone, I think, is going to be there. Steve McNiven, the artist of such classic storylines as Old Man Logan and Marvel Civil War. I'm probably going to have some original art for sale. I think I'm going to buy a page of McNiven art or do it, get some sketches done. Interview him for the show. That will be awesome. Then you got the Hartford Comic Con. And I still got to figure out when that is. I just know it's got Julie Lauren Adams. She is the actress in two of the greatest movies of all time. That will be Clerks. Oh, not Clerks. Duh! Mallrats and Chasing Amy. And she was also in Big Daddy. She was in a movie called Goose. She is in a couple of the classic episodes of Married with Children. And I'm going to go to Hartford Comic Con and interview her. As soon as I find out what the fucking dates are. Because their website kind of sucks. That's either here or there. I think what we'll do is we'll play with Never Saw. We'll go on to the next clip. Now that we've done conventions, and we talked about the Boston Comic Con happening July 31st, August 2nd. The Connecticut Comic Con happened August 15th, 16th, and 17th. And a good friend of the shows, we love him like a brother from another mother, Kenny Lawrence, Superman Megafest, happening November 21st and 22nd over in Framingham, Massachusetts. And of course, somewhere in between there, you got November 6th, 7th, and 8th, you got the Rhode Island Comic Con happening, yes, at the Civic Center. If anyone calls it the Dunkin' Donuts Center, I will punch them in the fucking junk. It's the Civic Center. I don't know why Dunkin' Donuts had to fucking change the name, but I'll get on that at another day and another time as we all testify what really grinds my gears. Fuck Dunkin' Donuts. Open YouTube.
Search. Selected. Search. Button.
Now this song is going to go out to a good friend of the show. Someone who's been on the show a couple times and will be coming back hopefully next week. He's a comic book historian. He's a movie historian. Works tirelessly to help the vets, you know, disabled veterans. He's an advocate. That is cool as Paul Hammond, which we're going to get some Monday Night Raw, you know, feedback in a minute. But, you know, Joey Kramer, I can't wait to have you back on the show. You know a lot about music, a lot about comics. Can't wait to have you on again. I love you, buddy, and I hope you're feeling better.
Selected. Search. Button. Text field. Voice search. Button.
Johnny Cash, no grave can hold me down.
Channel, playlist, default, resolve, ain't no grave, can't hold my body down. Johnny Cash, 6 million for... Playing advert, video player, heading.
You ain't never been hit by a real man.
Maybe, let's go. Ad can now be skipped.
Yeah, put your suspensions up. You have 0 income. Yeah, I like this thing to show that.
Video skip ad button. Video player heading.
There ain't no grave can hold my body down. There ain't no grave can hold my body down. When I hear the trumpet sound, I'm gonna rise right out of the ground. Ain't no grave can hold my body down. Well, look way down the river, and what do you think I see? I see a band of angels, and they're coming after me. Ain't no grave can hold my body down. There ain't no grave can hold my body down. Well, look down.
Of all time, Johnny Cash. That goes to my good buddy, Joey Kramer. Do you even have a name for your company, Joe? I'll ask it the next time we chat. But thank you for all you've done for the podcast. Thank you for all the support. Thank you for all the friendship, all the advice. Always coming on. And I really do love you, buddy. I mean, no man is an island unto himself. I mean, as long as you're a pimp, positive, inspiration, motivated person, and you live your life with conviction and education, and you go out and you fight for what you believe, then you know what, man? Just never give up. Always put one fist in the air, go, it's clapper time! And go whoop some monkey ass today in life! Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'd like to give another special shout out before I give my Monday Night Raw review and talk some DC comic stuff to Jessica. Hey, Jess, I hope you're having an awesome, magical, and special vacation. I miss you. I miss our chats. I'm going to have you on again. You know, I'm kind of swept down, you know, between packing, moving. Hopefully going to review Minions and Ant-Man, you know, sometime next week. Just a lot to get done and a little time to do it. But we will move forward. We will whoop that monkey ass. Buckle, 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 pow, with a picky, 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 pow. Oh, boy. Ha-ha. And then we'll go to Disney World. And we'll party like it's 1999. Ha-ha. Oh, boy. Yeah, Mickey. We're going to do that. We're going to party, yo. Ha-ha. Tell me about the wine. Tell me about the wine. Ha-ha. Oh, boy! Ha-ha! After you taste the kiss of Disney World, ha-ha! Oh, boy! You should celebrate with that special woman in your life, ha-ha! Just like I'm gonna do with Minnie. Oh, boy! With abduction wine, ha-ha! www.abcducitwine.com Ha-ha! Oh, boy! Mickey Mouse Club's abduction wine, ha-ha! Oh, boy! I drink it with Minnie, and I go, right off her breast of awesomeness! Ha-ha! Oh, boy! Abduction wine! When you want to wine, dine in 69 degrees! Ha-ha! Oh, boy! Ha-ha! Hey, Alien Rob! Ha-ha! Oh, boy! Hey, Alien Rob is in the, you know, Musketeer Hall of Fame! Ha-ha! Oh, boy! Boy, oh, boy, oh, boy! Ha-ha! Now back to Adam! Ha-ha! Oh, boy! Abduction wine! Ha-ha! Oh, boy! Thank you, Mickey Mouse! You know, yeah, Abduction Wine is a great wine. Alien Rob, thank you for all your love, all your support. You should try the Cosmic White. I am going to do something very special with Rob soon. And hopefully I'm going to bring him on to, you know, so we can make that announcement together sometime in the near future. Because, you know. Alien Rob, you're in my thoughts, you're in my prayers, and, you know, Monday Night Raw, I am a wrestling fan. Monday Night Raw last night was awesome and amazing from start to finish. From the opening vignette of Paul Heyman talking hyping up the fight between Brock Lesnar and Seth Rollins, all the way to the context, the contract signing with Brock Lesnar and Seth Rollins, and Brock Lesnar taking Kane Suplex City, taking Seth Rollins to Suplex City. This makes me want to get the, you know, cannot wait to watch, you know, Battleground this Sunday. It looks amazing. The segment of the night had to be the Divas. Ton of Divas is airing on the E! Network on Wednesday nights. The Bella Twins and Alicia Fox are the face of the Divas division. Nikki Bella, who's married to John Cena. Brie Bella, who's married to Daniel Bryan. Now, Alicia Fox, who stars on some crappy show on the Sci-Fi Network. You know, most of their original shows just suck monkey balls, and yes, I said it. I'm not a big fan of Sci-Fi's original programming. Just not a fan. Not enough time, too many great stuff. Gotham, Strain Season 2, they had to watch Sunday's episode. The Flash, Arrow, just so much. I do not need, if the Sci-Fi makes that, here's an idea, make something compelling that people actually want to watch, and actually put it on a time where people actually want to watch it. During the summertime? School in summertime? You know, on a Friday night at 8 o'clock, most people from the age of 18 to the age of 49 want to go out and do stuff. Barbecue, carnivals, big band concerts, all sorts of cool stuff. We got Hulu, YouTube, we can watch TV whenever the fuck we want. I mean, put on something compelling and maybe we'll go to the club at 9 o'clock instead of 8 and we'll sit down and we'll watch something like The Fabulous Killjoys. The show sucks. I'm going to say it. You know, but when you had Paige come down, and then you had Becky Lynch, Sarah Dukes, and woo! The daughter of the limousine riding, jet plane flying, we are doing kiss stealing, son of a bitch! That would be Charlotte, the daughter of Ric Flair, come out. And then you had Naomi and Tamina come out. Just awesome. 9 p.m. One notification. Let's see who'll be interrupting the podcast with a text, huh? New messages? But that was the highlight of the show. You have a message from him. It says, "Way Adam, so sorry I didn't get back to you. Got caught up yesterday. I was pretty busy today. Do you need anything? Give me a call. Would you like to reply?" Yes. Okay, what do you want to say to them? I am good, period. I'll give you a call in a few minutes, period. I love you, period.
Your message to me says, "I am good. I'll give you a call in a few minutes. I love you. Ready to send it?"
Yes.
Done.
New messages?
There are no new messages.
Sorry, I had to add, just take care of Cousin Mem for a second. You know, I love Mem. But then,
listen.
Once again, they make the U.S. title, the U.S. championship, important. New messages?
Would you like to reply?
No.
That's the last message.
But, you know, it was just an amazement segment for female wrestling. And maybe, you know, Stephanie McMahon, we can make the Divas division something special like they have over in the TNA Knockouts. And with TNA ain't being worth a sack of shit right now, if anyone knows, what channel Destination America is on Cablevision, please let me know. Please email comicpimpvip@gmail or call 201-675-2104 and let Blind Adam, the comic pimp, know. The only time I watch TNA anymore is on YouTube. And it's usually a couple weeks or a couple months after the fact. So it's all... I love the Dollhouse. I love, Taryn Terrell. I mean, they're doing a great job over there. Now let's see if WWE can finally follow suit. Total Divas looks awesome. And I just cannot wait. The U.S. title, John Cena versus Kevin Owens, man, is going to be the match you're going to want to watch Sunday night. I think Kevin Owens is going to be the new U.S. champ. Kevin Owens versus Dolph Lundgren, Rocky caricature, the Russian dude. The Russian dude who's all upset because Lana doesn't like him anymore. And it looks like he's got Summer Rae with him. I mean, can we just let Summer Rae fucking wrestle, please? That would be cool. But I give Monday Night Raw 4 pimp slaps out of 5. Bam, 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 bam. Yep. Bam, 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 rubble. Son of Bonnie Rubble. He goes, bam, bam, bam. He's bam, bamming it all over Pebble's face. Yeah, yeah, yeah. There was sex in Bedrock. Just wasn't talked about. Testify! Awesome sauce! Also, the Monday Night Raw review is brought to you by the official Gentleman's Club of the Awesome Sauce Comics podcast. That would be Scores Gentleman's Club, where I'm going sometime between tonight and Monday. Just trying to get a lot done, a little time to do it. I just really adore that place. Please tell them Blind Adam sent you, 212-868-4900. ScoresNY.com for all your adult entertainment and Gentlemen's Club needs. I love you guys at Scores. I will be coming in. Now that I'm back from Ohio, because that was an emergency trip I had to make. Gotta make sure Johnny, TJ Buddy got home safe and sound. And he had a traveling buddy to keep him awake. And I'd like to thank my good buddies, Gotham Cruisers, for all their hospitality. If you ever want a Batmobile made for yourselves, you contact Doug Hines at Gotham Cruisers, who I am going to try to see if I can get him to sponsor the show a little bit. Just got a lot of really awesome stuff that I'm lining up. And I'm going to go with the last song of the show, and then we're going to talk some DC, and then I got to get out of here. Open YouTube.
YouTube. Video player. Heading. Video. Pause and collapse video. Results. Ain't no great result. Refund. Playlist. Channel. Selected. Search. Button. Text field. Clear search. Voice search. Button. Voice search.
Beavis and Butthead. Man in the box.
Bad. Refund. Result. Beavis and Butthead Ice Ice Baby Vanilla Ice Man in the Box. More at Beavis and Butthead / Nirvana. Heart-shaped box. Fork. More at Beavis and Butthead Ice Ice Baby Vanilla Ice Man in the Box. Alice in Chains. 2002.
Wah, 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 wah. Christopher! That was the greatest, one of the greatest cartoon of all time. One of them, anyways. Beavis and Butthead.
Beavis. App switcher. Home. YouTube. Close YouTube. Portrait. Home. Home. Messages. Double tap to open.
That was, just brings back so many memories. Beavis and Butthead. Me and my brother Chris, 20 years ago, Grandma was alive. You know, I was only 21, he was only 14, and we had one of the greatest summers of all time. And I might just, before I move out, I might just do something very rare. I might just actually bring him on the show to say thank you. You know? But, yeah, man. And I have a question before we get into DC comic movie talk. I was watching clips from the 2011-ish Beavis and Butthead season that came back. The ones where they're making fun of Snooki, and they're making fun of, you know, those pregnant teenage whores and, you know, teenage mom, you know, I don't know how to buy a fucking condom because it's too difficult. Yeah, good going, Dr. Drew. Tara makes a sex tape. Nothing wrong with that. I haven't seen it yet. But at least, you know, what's her face? Amanda, Panda, Amber, whatever the fuck, she's in jail and rehab. You got Janelle constantly in and out of jail. Nice going, Dr. Drew. You know, you got these girls who want to get pregnant just to be on MTV. What's up with this? I mean, back in the day, which may have been a Tuesday. Happy Tuesday, everyone. MTV was awesome. You had Kennedy Deal music videos. You had the Headbangers Ball with Ricky Ratman. You got Beavis and Butthead, the Max, the Head, the Undergrads. You know, you got the Tom Green Show. You had Singled Out. You had quality television. I mean, every one of these little teenage bitches who I can't stand except for Farrah. I have respect for Farrah Abraham because, you know, hey, she's supporting her. She's actually not in prison. And she actually works to her money, and she's really sweet to her fans. And, you know, I met her at Exotica 2013. Exotica is a porn convention in New Jersey, and she was doing pictures and the whole thing. She was really nice. In fact, I'm not sure, maybe try to get her on the show, I don't know. You know, but, you know, I mean, granted, she was in an episode, she was in the season finale of Botch, which I haven't seen yet. You know, she was on Couples Therapy, you know. But, you know, she hasn't been in jail. She's, you know, not like Amber and Janelle, stupid bitches. Testify. You know. And whatever happened to the awesomeness that was Heidi Montag? Heidi Montag was, she's sexy, she was awesome, she was a positive role model for young ladies, and she, the Hills got canceled from MTV, you know, and she was on some competition show on VH1 to get her home restaurant, which didn't pan out, you know, but, whatever happened to the awesome sauce that's Heidi Montag, you know, what's up with that, you know, but Beavis and Butthead was one of the greatest cartoons. You know, didn't have a plot, just two, you know, very mentally undeveloped, behind the learning curve teenagers, you know, who are virgins, who want to score with girls, they want to go out and have adventures, they want to get money, and they just sit around, they eat junk food, watch music videos, And, you know, it's even, they rule, they suck. And it's kind of interesting that the Ice Baby from Vanilla Ice didn't even get commentary from Beavis and Butthead. That's how bad it totally sucked, monkey balls! Testify! Testify! You know, I kind of lied about there not being, like, one more song. Open YouTube.
Menu. Button. Recommended. The new discoveries. Music. Selected. Search. Button. Text field. Voice search. Button.
That's Suicide Squad. First look.
Result. Suicide Squad. Comic-Con First Look, HD. Third more. Suicide Squad. Comic-Con First Look Trailer Reaction and Review. More. Suicide Squad. Comic. Video player. Video is loading. Heading.
It's taken some work, but I finally have them. The worst of the worst.
Trailer that was shown at Comic-Con San Diego last week.
Suicide.
And that, my friends, is the...
Oh, YouTube. Close YouTube.
Definition of awesome sauce.
Oh.
Margot Robbie as Harley Quinn.
Double tap to open.
If you cannot get your copies of Batman Adventures 12, Batman Love, Mad Love, Batman Harley Quinn, or any of the key Harley Quinn appearances, now, if you don't have them now, now's the time to buy them. That trailer, wow. Margot Robbie will be the live action Harley Quinn for quite some time. It just looks awesome. Hey, Marvel, step up your game starting with, you better step up your game starting with Captain America, because DC's going to fire that first shot on March 25th with Superman versus Batman. Superman versus Batman with Ben Affleck. And let me get something out of the way for the player haters. Ben Affleck is gonna make an awesome Batman. He is the goddamn Batman. I mean, if you want to blame someone for what Daredevil the movie was, god forbid, awful, Mark Steven Johnson, who couldn't direct a fucking hefty bag, let alone a superhero movie, is the whole reason. It wasn't Ben Affleck's fault. It wasn't Jennifer Garner's fault. It wasn't the late, great Michael Clark Duncan's fault. It was Mark Steven Johnson's fault.
5930.
You know? It really was. I mean, you don't just take a couple of classic stories by Frank Miller, cut them out of comics, paste them all, saying, this is what we're shooting today. You gotta have a real script. You know, and that's the reason it took up to the Netflix show starring Charlie Cox, Deborah Whitmore, Vince DiNaggio, John Vanendar as the Punisher. You know, to really redeem what happened in that movie. Even though Colin Farrell was fucking awesome as shit. You know? Ben Affleck is going to be awesome. He's going to be amazing. He's been awesome ever since Mallrats, when Kevin Smith discovered a young Ben Affleck. He was awesome in Dazed and Confused, Argo, Dogma, Hollywoodland, Reindeer Games. Yes, I liked Reindeer Games. Pearl Harbor sucked ass, but that's because it was Michael Bay. Fuck Michael Bay. Guess that's that? You know, but the Suicide Squad movie with Will Smith as Deadshot. You know, Batman 59, Detective Comics 474, Suicide Squad number 1, Legends number 3. It kind of sucks that you won't have the Suicide Squad on air anymore, but wow. I wasn't expecting Will Smith to sell me on the character, but just awesome and amazing. And then, of course, you got, you know, Rick Flagg in there. And you got the Enchantress, Captain Boomerang. You know, just the Legends miniseries and Legends number 3, the first appearance of Amanda Waller. That's Legends number 1, I think. But 1 and 3 should be 100-hour books by the end of the year. Suicide Squad, New 52 issues are smoking hot! Issue number 1, number 1 second print. Issues 6 and 7 will show the origin of the New 52 Harley Quinn. You know, just awesome and amazing. You know, I'm really, really digging what, you know, that DC is going to bring the game to Marvel in 2016. I mean, I think 20th Century Fox, starting with Fantastic Four, and August 7th, is going to start to bring the game to the Marvel Cinematic Universe as well. And a great time to be a fan of comic book movies. And also a great time to be a fan of comic books. I read the Dan Slott and... It's either Andy or Adam, one of the fucking Kubert brothers. I think it was Andy Kubert. Amazing Spider-Man, Renew Your Vows number 2. Which is telling the story of Peter Parker and Mary Jane still married, with their daughter Anna fighting the Reactor, a Ricochet, or whatever the fuck you pronounce the villain's name, who's in this portion of Battleworld and the Secret Wars. And it makes me wonder, hey, Joe Quesada, maybe you were wrong. I actually think a married Peter Parker is still awesome. You know? And I really think One More Day, as much as it sucks, you know, I say, why don't we have a miniseries, another miniseries after this, exploring a Peter Parker and, you know, Mary Jane Watson Parker and Annie. I'm loving this. You know, that dream sequence for issue one, you know, where Peter killed Eddie, the Eddie Brock Venom, to save his family, having that nightmare and that guilt, just awesome, amazing. The sinister, even though this reactor is a crap villain, you know, you still got the classic Sinister Six in there. You had a cameo by fucking Power Pack. Power Pack, for crying out loud. You know, which kind of, you know, which is the anti-kidnapping PSA comic, Spider-Man and Power Pack. You know, if you can find that in the newspaper strip form, grab it. I love those PSA comics of the 80s. Spider-Man and Luke Cage, they stop smoking, the anti-bullying issue, the anti-kidnapping molestation issue. Just awesome stuff. I mean, Spider-Man Renewed Vows number one, number two, is probably my favorite comic of the summer. I give it 5 pimp slaps out of 5 pimp slaps as we touch the sky! And that, I'm going to say, thank you all for being on the loving, awesome Sauce Stanley. I love you all. Keep one foot in the gutter, one fist in the goal. Too hot to handle, too cold to hold. Blind out of saying good afternoon!
104.41. Stop recording button. Enter.